data presentation. At the end of this lecture, you should be able to tabulate data and present data accordingly. You should be able to construct a histogram, a pie chart, and a bar chart. And you should be able to differentiate between bar charts and histograms. This question says, the students in a class were asked to state their favorite subjects. The results are given in the chart below. Complete the frequency column in the table. Illustrate the data using a bar chart and a pie chart. We will start by completing the frequency column in the table. The first subject is economics, and the tally is 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then we have a stroke across it, which is represents 5. So the frequency here is 5. For history, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we write down 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we fill that with 7. 1, 2, 3 for English. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Our total, therefore, will be 30. This is the frequency column. 5, 9, 7, 3, 6, and 30. The next question had asked us to construct the bar chart and the pie chart. We start with the bar chart. You plot a graph of frequency here, this column here, against the subject. We have different subjects: economics, history, mathematics, English, and geography. This is the axis for the frequency. So for economics, the frequency is 5. So we have that our bar chart starts here at 5. And we have this bar here. Then the next subject is history. And we place our bar chart for history here. So this is where it stops. History is 9. Then we have that the next number is mathematics, 7. So we have 7 here. And we have English to be 3. We have our 3 here. And then we have our geography to be 6. And our geography is aligned on this. So this is the bar chart for the above data. Note the gaps between the bars for a bar chart. In bar charts, you have gaps between the bars. The second part of the question had said we should construct a pie chart. A pie chart usually represent the quantities as sectors in a circle, and the entire circle equals 360 degrees. To therefore illustrate the above data with a pie chart, we find out what angle equals one student. Remember, we have the subject and we have the frequency. In other words, the number of students for every subject. For example, in economics, 5 students said economics was their favorite subject. 9 students said history was their favorite subject. 7 students said mathematics was their favorite subject, and so on. So to illustrate the data with a pie chart, we find out what angle equals one student. There are 360 degrees in a circle, and we have a total of 30 students. The angle for one student, therefore, will be 360 divided by 30, which is 12. To therefore find the construct the pie chart for every student, we simply multiply the numbers we have in the frequency by 12. So, for example, on the economics column, we will multiply 5 by 12 to give us 60. For history, it will be 9 times 12 to give us 108, and so on. I illustrate in the next slide. This is how it looks like. So, 5, this is the tally, this is the frequency, and this is the calculation. Remember, we had 360 divided by 30, which is 12. So 5 times 12 is 60. 9 times 12 is 108. 7 times 12 is 84. 3 times 12 is 36. And 6 times 12 is 72. The sum of this angle should total 360 degrees. and you use these different angles to construct your pie chart. Using a protractor and a ruler alongside a compass, you construct the following pie chart. So the economics angle, this angle here is the angle 60 degrees. You construct using your protractor and compass the angle for history, which is 108 degrees. You construct for mathematics, which is 84 degrees. You construct 84 degrees for mathematics. You construct 36 degrees for English. And you construct 72 degrees for geography. This is the pie chart. The data in this pie chart shows that the most favorite subject is history. As a matter of fact, if you look at the pie chart, you see that history has the widest sector. The most favorite subject or the item that appears the most is called the mode. And you can also see that English is the least favorite subject.